get into tech, and I bring to you 21 Conversations. In this series, we'll be talking to 21 different people from Signet InfoTech who will talk about business, leadership, the world of information technology, and about their own experiences and many more things. So here we go. Hi and welcome to the fourth episode of 21 Conversation. And today we have with us Mr. Premal Dave, who is known for his pragmatic approach and to the point communication. We'll be speaking to him about the world of digital transformation.
Hi Premal, good morning and welcome to 21 Conversation. My first question is obviously regarding automation and how automation is acting today in the current scenario.
Sure. Thanks for having me for this discussion. And it's quite a valid point that we are talking about the automation, especially in the last 2 years since we are into this pandemic situation. If you ask me, basis my experience and dealing with a lot of customers, I see there are three trends which is quite prevalent. From an organization point of view, the first thing is, yes, we generate data, but there are a wide variety of data. So it's not just the traditional data that we generate, but it's a wide variety of data. So within the automation space, when you talk about data, you have to find the way to, how we process that data and the technology around storing those data. So that will be one of the key aspects of automation. How do we automate? Because retrieving those data manually will not be possible. Storing those data, so you have to take them for the security element. Will be the key concern. Second point I would say, the automation piece, as you highlighted, it's not just about automating one piece. It's businesses are talking about automating the entire value chain. So you cannot automate one part of your business and believe that it will work and that will achieve your business objective, but it's actually the entire value chain that you have to automate. Third thing, which is more of on the roles and responsibility side, the CIOs and the technical leaders, or I would say technology leaders, so far what I have seen personally, that they sit behind as an IT function, they execute or implement the IT strategy of the organization, but now that paradigm is also changing, that space is also changing. So CIOs and the technology leaders, they are getting into the customer experience front, they are leading that front. And at the same time, they're designing those experiences for a customer. Yeah. And also, they are also leading the operation, how the IT can be used in the operation.
And Premal, the second question is about a side hero that mm-hmm. is called digital maturity that nobody talks about, but is kind of more or equally important like digital transformation. So I want to know more about that.
People do talk about, any material or any content that you pick on website or on blogs, you will find people talk about digital transformation more in compared to the digital maturity. How your company will respond to whatever the technological changes in the marketplace. So without assessing current digital maturity, you would not be able to define your digital transformation journey or a roadmap. So I think to me, that is a first step towards the digital transformation. And the way I position in my own mind, it's almost like a continuous process, digital maturity is. And within digital maturity, you have a digital transformation as a program, which takes care of the current objective.
Talking about digital maturity and digital transformation, why do we need to do that?
If you look at from the leadership or from the top management point of view, you want to implement digital transformation only because you want to have access to more data and the insight about those data. So whatever insight we can generate from that data, that is why we want to implement a digital transformation initiative or I would say a program.
What will be the future? Robotic humans or humanized robots?
My submission to your thing is, it has to be a bit of both, and that's how we can leverage the expertise of human and the expertise of technology, be it RPA, be it AI. So I think it's going to be a bit of both.
Yes,
so
I know you're doing PhD. So I want to know about your interest AI.
Sure. I'm quite fascinated about fintech space, what is happening in that space. And I think that area is going to grow tremendously over the next 5 to 10 years. So the area of interest is definitely fintech. And within fintech, you pick up any sub area likes of digital lending or even payments, not many things have already been done.
Yeah.
But I believe a lot many things will change over a period of next 5 to 10 years, and that's where my personal interest lies. And you rightly said I'm pursuing a PhD, and that is the main reason why I'm doing that. So if I combine whatever is happening within fintech and the power of data or AI, ML, I think that will create a very unique combination and a proposition for any functions, to lead in their specific domain. So I think that's something where I love reading about, and also talking about to my colleagues, to my customers, whenever there's an opportunity.
Okay.
Thank you.